But first up tonight, the World Heavyweight Championship. A few weeks ago on Raw, Eric Bischoff resurrected the World Heavyweight Championship and presented it to Triple H. That had a lot of folks wondering whether it was a legitimate title, or did Bischoff buy some old relic on eBay and pass it off as his latest gimmick? Believe it or not, the World Heavyweight title is the oldest and arguably the most prestigious title in professional wrestling. Although it's new to Raw, the World Heavyweight title dates back to 1904, when George Hackenschmidt was the first recognized world champion. From there, its history becomes somewhat cloudy until the late Lou Thesz consolidated all of the world titles into the NWA Championship in 1948. In 1989, the NWA title morphed into the WCW Championship. With nearly 100 years of history behind it, the World Heavyweight Championship is an icon among icons.
This event, one fall for the World's Heavyweight Championship.
And ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion.
The winner, a new World Heavyweight Champion!
If you look at what had become the WCW World title and you look at its lineage over the past 30, 40, 50 years, it really all started with the NWA. You look at Buddy Rogers is one of the great names that had that title.
I want to congratulate you and wish you a lot of luck as a new World Heavyweight Champion as recognized by the National Wrestling Alliance.
There's just, you know, scores of names that people all remember that, you know, at one point or another have held that title. Big names, important people in this business.
A man that won the NWA Championship his very first time, Gene Kaninsky. Many consider the toughest man to ever hold the NWA Championship. Handsome Harley Race.
World NWA belt, the one that Kaninsky, the Funks, Jack Briscoe, myself, Dusty Rhodes wore, was owned by the NWA. And whoever the champion was at that time had to put up a $25,000 deposit. When you lost the title, you got the money back. Old style respect was still in place and it was huge. That was the deal, to be the world, to be the NWA world champion, there was nothing like it.
This is the greatest night of my life. And I can't thank you. Thank you very much.
Winning the title was a huge, it was obviously a lot of diplomacy involved, there's always politics at that level, but being the champion of the NWA was a huge honor because it was decided upon by a vote of 9 different people, including Vince McMahon's father, which is still strange to me that the man that owned the competition was on the board of directors, but it was a great part of the history of our business. Vince Sr. was so respected that even though he didn't use the NWA champion, his opinion and what he thought about our business meant so much to everybody else that Vince Sr. was on the board of directors.
This is Ric Flair, your world's heavyweight wrestling champion. I represent the NWA. This is World Championship Wrestling.
The WCW belt actually was a belt. The physical belt itself was designed and made by a silversmith from Reno, Nevada. Jimmy Crockett had it made. When he saw the NWA coming to the point where they were no longer going to be able to compete as a separate entity with the WWF.
When Ted Turner bought the company in 1988 from the Crocketts, who was at that time operating their business as the NWA territory. So that's how the NWA title eventually became the WCW title.
The WCW championship, you know, it goes back a long ways. It goes back to Nature Boy Buddy Rogers, Ric Flair. I mean, there's so much, you know, history in that championship.
My fondest memory would be winning the heavyweight title, you know, for the first time.
Diamond Dallas Page is the heavyweight champion of the world. I can't believe it.
We all know it's predetermined in the whole deal. But to me, when you become the heavyweight champion of the world, it's like winning the Oscar in our business. It means you are one of the very best in the world at what we do.
Finally, you know, winning that night and holding that belt in my hand.
We've got a new champion! Oh my God!
God, Booker T's the world champion!
He won the gold! He is the top man in this sport!
Knowing that, you know, guys like Ric Flair and, you know, Hogan and Rogers, you know, and those guys have, you know, wore that same belt down that same aisle and performed in front of millions of people, it was a great feeling and something I'll never forget.
Having the WCW championship, you know, from Hulk Hogan, you gotta realize that was my first match.
And the Giants got the belt!
There was a lot of pressure I put on myself when, you know, I was first the WCW champion, when I got to carry the championship. When you've got the prestige of being the man, you know, and the man is the guy with the championship, you're the man for the hour. You know, if the houses are down, it's your fault. If the ratings are down, it's your fault. Regardless, because you're the man that's leading the ship.
The guy he sent down that ramp to get in that ring at night wearing the championship belt, and I feel that was the way it was when I won in 81 right up to now, was the guy the company felt could carry the company, lead the company, and make the people that are watching TV and in that arena believe that he is worthy of being the world champion.
Every time a company has done well, it's because they've had a strong champion. Hulk Hogan, WCW is a strong champion. Sting was a strong champion. Ric Flair was a strong champion. So, I mean, these guys set the bar, so to speak, for drawing the houses, making the money, and making the other guys money.
When I hear my name mentioned in the same sentence with guys like, you know, Flair, Rhodes, and Rogers, for myself to be in there and to have closed the show out, finished WCW off, being champion, it's an amazing feeling. I think you can ask 99 and 10% of the guys in this business. It's just a great honor, period, to be a champion, and especially when you're called the world champion.
Do I like the responsibility? Do I like the prestige and the honor of being a champion? You betcha. Anybody in this business, they're not in it to be a champion. They don't need to be in it.
It is the most prestigious thing that anybody can possibly have in professional wrestling. Dusty Rhodes was one of the greatest performers in the history of our business. And his love and his passion for our business made him a good champion.
Dusty Rhodes, live in public, babies. And I'm here to tell you your coupon clipping, Copenhagen dipping. Sorry, I got carried away. I love Dusty. You know, Dusty is one of the most charismatic champions I've ever seen.
I always enjoyed the American Dream. And he's just always so entertaining. He's so charismatic.
It's a moment in the history of this sport that we will never forget. It's a career that goes on and on and on. Ric Flair is the heavyweight champion of the world.
Ric Flair, I admire him, you know, I mean, as far as being in this business, being going up and down the road and putting so many miles on his body and still wanting to be champion and wanting to go out there and perform at that level. He has been, you know, one of the greatest champions of all time. I can't honestly say that.
Ric Flair and the WCW world title were synonymous in many people's minds, and in some ways, it still is.
I remember the first time I met Ric Flair in Chicago, I had to go outside and take a breath because I almost hyperventilated meeting him because I was like, oh my God, that was, I mean, he just walked by. And I was like,
there's never been a man to win the world's championship who was undefeated.
We've got a new heavyweight champion of the world. The first undefeated man in the history of this sport to ever win the world championship.
Bill Goldberg is an example of what a promotion can do with a guy if they want to make a star out of him.
Quite frankly, it would have been nice if Bill would have been a little more prepared, you know, a little more experienced and seasoned as a performer.
There's a guy that slid in, had the right gimmick, the right time, made a great impact, and you know, made his money, saved his money, and now he's in a good position. He doesn't have to work if he doesn't want to.
And a diamond cutter! 1, 2! Oh my God, Paige is a world champ again!
I don't believe it!
DDP, title reigns in WCW, all manufactured.
I thought he was a great champion. I thought it probably came a little bit late for him. I thought Paige, you know, worked awful hard and probably should have been champion a lot earlier than he got the championship, but at least he did get it because he deserved it.
That's a tough one. That's a tough one. Because we were such good friends and because I wanted it for him and I wanted it for him, and I wanted it to work for him.
In his heart and in his head, he believed he was good enough to be there. That's all that matters sometimes.
It's over! Oh, we got a new champion! 9 times! Sting has done it! 9 times!
Sting turned it on and wanted to do what he wanted to do. It was just, I mean, I thought he was so excited.
I never really got the sense that Sting was 100% committed, but I always felt as though, for one reason or the other, and I could never put my fingers on it, that he was holding back just a little bit.
Some of the quote-unquote upper echelon guys in WCW at that time really didn't want to give him his just due. I think he was not fully used to his potential.
The one thing I feel bad about for Sting is he never had a chance to work with Vince McMahon. He would have been, I think, one of the biggest stars in the history of the WWF, WWE. He had it all.
Hulkamania lives in World Championship Wrestling. It's the greatest day in the history of professional wrestling. The Hulkster becomes the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World.
Hulk Hogan and the WCW title changed the fortunes of World Championship Wrestling.
Probably the greatest champion of all time.
One thing about Hogan, he had the magic.
Hulk is the man. You know, I want to sit here and tell you that he wasn't, but Hulk is the man. And I think everybody that ever doubted that found out at WrestleMania. And in a couple cities there afterward, just how big Hulk is in our business.
He's still got that aura about him that makes him Hulk Hogan.
He'll go down in history, in my opinion, until I see something different, you know, as the greatest champion of our time.